Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We're down here at Collier & Austin Boxing Gym. We've got Matty Ryan with us. Good to see you down here today, Matty. Is it your first day back today?
No, I've had a few sessions last week, but it's like my first proper week back in. If that makes sense. I come in last week, taking over, skipping Shadow. Obviously, the lads have got big fights on, aren't they, at the end of the month, so I'm just here, getting back into the swing of things again. It's good to be back now. Yeah. Mind's at rest again now. I'm ready to go again, I'm ready to go. So, get back to the drawing board and go from there, mate.
Okay, mate. Now, I know, obviously, you know, we didn't catch up straight after the fight, because obviously, you're disappointed after the fight. We're talking about the fight with Ted Cheeseman, of course, on the Matchroom Bill.
Yeah.
You know, just give us your, now you've had time to think about it and reflect on it. So what are your thoughts about the way the night unfolded?
Well, the game plan just crashed it. The game plan was to stay away from him the first few rounds and take him into deep water, because he would have to work to get to me now if I'm on that move. But now I've watched the fight back over and over again, and you can see those body shots have slowed me down, and I was moving a bit too much to tie myself. No, it was like I should have walked a bit instead of bouncing. It looked like I was like an injured animal. So he was thriving off it, and pushing forward and trapping me on the ropes and catching me, and body shots and slowing down. It's all learning. I've learned a lot from it. I've had time out, I've thought about it, and I've learned a lot from it. Put it behind me. It's a loss, but I'm gutted about it. But it's boxing at the end of the day, and anything can happen. So yeah. And it was all just down to myself. Nothing to do with Pat, Paul. They done their everything correct. It was just. Game plan didn't work. Like I said, I think I was moving a bit too much, letting him think that he was dominating me, and he hurt me. But
I mean, we've got to give some credit to Ted as well.
Of course, mate. Going into that fight, I knew it was a tough fight. He's a good kid. He was a good amateur. He's becoming a good pro now. So I give a lot of credit to him, and I wish him best of luck when he goes for that British title shot.
I mean, in all honesty, he looked heavy-handed, and the fact that you got up the first time as well, and carried on.
Well, that's all everyone said. He said, keep away from him, he's heavy-handed, and he's accurate. That's what this one said, he's very accurate. Past people who've boxed him have said, he's an accurate puncher, and he is, he caught with some nice shots through the middle. But that busted my nose. I didn't even click on that. It got me, and I was wondering why my nose was leaking. I was wondering why it was. And obviously, so he was very heavy-handed, but very accurate.
I mean, people, were concerned about your officers. Just not just in terms of the physicality. Just you're a popular guy. Not a nice guy, and everyone likes you. And it's I mean, what have you got to say to people who haven't sort of seen you, since that? You're in a good place now.
A brilliant place now. Spoke with Pat. We put it behind us. He was just as gutted as me, Pat. So I'm in a good place now, and everyone, I can't thank everyone for the support. The support they give me. Everyone's telling me don't give up. You're better than that. You blah blah. Everyone's saying you've still got more to prove, and I believe I have. So, and I've told everyone it's a knock in the road. I don't need to give up boxing it happens.
Of course it doesn't.
But it's how you bounce back from it, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's how you
get
up and build yourself
up. And this guy Ted Cheeseman could go on to really
big things, really
big things. You know what I mean? Then you'll look.
Eddie Hearn said he's going on to big things. So, and I believe he will. He's a good boxer. So and just getting in that ring and actually getting on with one of my fights on Sky.
Yeah,
that's all what
if
in the beginning though. So it's good. I enjoyed it. Really enjoyed it.
Yeah, so I mean there's still loads of options open to you, isn't there? I don't know how much we're allowed to say, but there's obviously I've heard some rumours can we say anything or not?
Yeah, of course.
So I've heard rumours that there might be some central area title fight coming up.
Hopefully we've asked for that against Darryl Sharp. Obviously I wanna try step up to middleweight now. I'm a big guy, and I reckon I'll carry some power at that weight. And I might look a bit healthier as well. So we've asked for that, so we're just waiting on what's going on with that. Hopefully it can happen, and it can happen on a big show. Yeah. Fingers crossed.
Brilliant. Well, listen, you're giving us thrills and spills, throughout
your... There's plenty more.
Plenty more to come from Matthew Ryan.
Yeah, definitely, mate.
I'll never forget the fight with Sonny Upton. I was there. Great fight.
Yeah, exactly. That should have been one of my really toughest fights, and that's one of the fights I enjoyed. Like with Darryl Sharp, Before that, I boxed Al Shadow on 8 rounds with him. And that was one of the good, and I enjoyed that. Previous fights, so all them, I've asked what rounds this, and them two fights, I never asked what round, I just went through it, enjoyed it, and no, I didn't care what round it was. And there were the 8 and 10 rounds, and I think they suit me better. So, yeah, that Sunny Upton fight was a brilliant fight. I still watch it now.
Yeah, you know, I'm not gonna lie, I watch it every time. All right, mate. Listen, great to catch up with you. Yeah. Good to see you, like, you know, in a good place, mate. Yeah. As you say, more to come from you, and we'll catch up with you soon, mate.
Top one.
Matty Ryan here. I'm Aki Kareem, British boxers. You know the score. Power.